السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد من على الأنبياء تقدم وكان أفصح العالمين منطقا إذا تكلم سيدنا ونبينا أبا القاسم محمد. اللهم يا ربنا زده شرفا وكرما وتعظيما وإجلالا وقدرا وصل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
الحمد لله الحمد لله نستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولا مثيل له في علو شأنه وعظيم سلطانه. ونشهد أن سيدنا وسندنا ومولانا محمدًا عبده وحبيبه ورسوله أرسله من أرجح العرب ميزانًا وأفصحها بيانًا فأوضح الطريقة ونصح الخليقة صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه وأولاده وذريته وخلفائه المهديين من بعده ووزرائه العاملين في عهده خصوصا منهم على الأئمة خلفاء رسول الله على التحقيق أمراء المؤمنين حضرات أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي ذوي القدر الجلي وعلى بقية الصحابة والتابعين رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين. أيها المؤمنون الحاضرون اتقوا الله وأطيعوه إن الله مع الذين اتقوا والذين هم محسنون. أيها المسلمون أيها المؤمنون أو مسلمز أو مؤمنز. This dunya is دار فناء والآخرة دار بقاء. This dunya is the dunya is the life that is going to be disappearing, extinguishing one day. And the آخرة is what going to be everlasting. And that's why it's more important to look for our akhirah than to look for our dunya. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, alayhi afdalu salatu wa salam, Sayyidina Muhammad said, لو كانت الدنيا تزن عند الله جناح بعوضة لما سقى منها شربة ماء أحد. If this dunya weighs a wing of a mosquito to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he would not have given anyone one cup of water. Means that this dunya doesn't weigh anything, has no value. Something has no value, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not destroy creation for something that has no value. He will not prevent water from creation for something that has no value. Something that has value, yes, Allah will prevent you from getting it because it has value. So Allah will prevent to give you akhirah, paradise, because it has value if you don't work for paradise. If you are not doing something for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will not give you heavens. But for dunya has no value. He gives you what you want. He lets you loose. Running, at the end, he will pull you back. What you will say? Can you say anything when he brings you back? You are in his presence, sending the angel of death, and say, now come to me. Can you say, no, leave me alone? No. You leave dunya and go. And your parents, your children, your family, everyone is crying for you. Crying and crying. No, be happy, smile. But from out of love, they are not happy. Because they think that this one is left dunya, but he left dunya to better place. He left dunya to akhirah. When Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this is an example of Sayyida Fatima al-Zahra, radiyallahu ta'ala anha wa ardaha wa alayha salam, when she saw Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam getting sick, she was the one that taking care of him. He was sweating and having fever. She was taking care of him, putting some pads, cold water pads on his forehead, on his face, to cool him down from this high fever. And she was crying. Because he is the seals of messengers. She has right to cry. She was crying. And then Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told her, come give me your ear. I want to whisper something in your ear. And he said something. She was laughing and smiling. Sayyida Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha wa ardaha said to Sayyida Fatima al-Zahra, what he said to you to make you happy and smiling after you were crying? She said, I will not tell you. This is between me and my father. When Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam left dunya, Sayyida Aisha kept asking. Came one day and said, Ya Fatima al-Zahra, what Prophet said to you in your ear? She wants to know. And she said, now I can tell you. He whispered in my ear when he saw me crying that he is leaving me. He told me, in 6 months you will be joining me. I was happy. Because I'm going to be with my Habib, with my lover, with my father, with the seals of messengers. I'm going to be with eternal life, not with this dunya life that has no value. Oh Muslims, we are getting these knowledges from women, from the family of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If not for the wives of Prophet, no one will understand or would have any understanding about Islamic religion from point of view of women. How Prophet was telling them what they have to do in their lives. All this information came to Sahaba from the wives of Prophet and daughters of Prophet. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not leave us without support. Hadith from Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying that كل أمر ذي بال لا يبدأ ببسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أقطع أو فهو أقطع. Any matter that concerns you that you want to do and you don't begin with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, that matter or that issue is going to be cut one day. It's not going to continue. Because anything has to continue, has to be eternal. Has to be from this, from heavens. And Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is the first revelation to Prophet when Allah said, Ya Muhammad, Iqra, Bismi Rabbika alladhi khalaq, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Allah gave us something important in our lives. Don't say, I am not doing well in this business or that business. Say, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. You want to eat, say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. You want to drink, say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. You finish, say Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. If it was not difficult, you must say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim on every bite you eat. But unfortunately, we forget. You open your store in the morning, say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. You open your door of your house, going out, say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, because there are too many shaitans outside. An Jabir ibn Abdullah قال, Jabir said, لما نزلت بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم هرب الغيم إلى المشرق. When that ayah came down, the clouds was running to the east. وسكنت الريح, and the wind became still. وهاج البحر, and the water and the oceans were, what you say in English, هاج, begin to rise up the waves. وأصغت البهائم بأذانها, and animals were listening to that verse, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. ورجمت الشياطين, and the devils were stoned. من السماء, from heavens. وحلف الله بعزته أن لا يسمى على شيء إلا بارك الله فيه. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave an oath that anyone recite Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim on everything he makes, barakah will be there. Oh Muslim, don't let the barakah to run away from you. Keep saying Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. And Ibn Mas'ud said, من أراد أن ينجيه الله من الزبانية التسعة عشر فليقرأ بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. He said that anyone who likes to be safe from angels of punishment, let him keep reciting بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ليجعل الله له بكل حرف منها جنة. Allah will give you from every letter of Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim when you are reciting a paradise. Count how many times you recite Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. On every letter you will be rewarded, because Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is 19 letters. وعن ابن مسعود قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من قرأ بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم كتب الله له بكل حرف 4,000 حسنة. He said, ابن مسعود, that Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, who recite بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم, Allah will write for him on every letter 4,000 good tidings, حسنة. ومحى عنه 4,000 سيئة. and he will erase for him on every letter 4,000 سيئات. ورفعه 4,000 درجة. And he will raise that person 4,000 levels in paradise. Oh Muslims, don't leave Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, because Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is the way for you to heaven. That's why Allah said Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim to Sayyidina Sulaiman. إنه من سليمان وإنه بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. When he wrote the letter to Sheba, to Balqis, to come to Sayyidina Musa and to Sayyidina Sulaiman and surrender and become Muslim, he wrote that letter, إنه من سليمان وإنه بسم الله الرحمن. It is from Sulaiman and it is بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وأن لا تعلوا علي وأتوني مسلمين. And don't think you are high. ببسم الله الرحمن الرحيم you can be down. A tyrant with بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم you read on him will be down. Oh Allah, رب العزة والعظمة, don't let us to be tyrant. Take shaitan away from us for the barakah of بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us remembering Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. وعن ابن عباس مرفوعا إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. ابن عباس said that إن المعلم إذا قال للصبي كل بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم كتب للمعلم وللصبي ولأبويه براءة من النار. ابن مسعود said that is the teacher, when the teacher teach the child to say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, you must teach your children. You must remind them to say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim on everything they are doing. When they wear their clothes, they say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. When they go to take shower, say A'udhu billahi minash shaitan ar-Rajim, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. When they eating, say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Every amal they do, say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Inna al-mu'allima idha qala lis-sabiyyi kul Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. If the teacher say to the child, say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Allah will write for the teacher and for the child and for the parents of the child, bara'atum min an-nar, innocence from hellfire. That person will go to paradise directly, because of the barakah of Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المستغفرين فيا فوزا للمستغفرين أستغفر الله. الحمد لله حمد الكاملين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. تعظيما لنبيه وتكريما لفخامة شأن صفيه, فقال عز وجل من قائل مخبرا وآمرا, إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي, يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد الناهي أمته عن دار الجحيم, مفخر العرب والعجم, مولانا ومولى العالمين المحترمين سيدنا أبي القاسم محمد. يا أيها المشتاقون نور جماله والمحتاجون شفاعته صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. وبارك اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات, واغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان, ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين وأعز كلمة هذا الدين وأذل الشرك والكافرين إنك على كل شيء قدير وبالإجابة جدير. وصلى الله على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. أقم الصلاة.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم. الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
لا إله إلا الله سيدنا ونبينا محمد رسول الله. اللهم ربنا رب هذه الدعوة التامة والصلاة.